This is Business Analytics Using Forecasting, and I'm Galit Shmueli. Before we start talking about forecasting or time series, we need to have a common language. Like with any language, we're going to have to learn some basic vocabulary. So we're going to start this session with looking at a few terms and notations that will be used throughout the course. The first two concepts are very basic. A time series is a series of measurements of a particular phenomenon taken over time. In other words, we're talking about temporal measurements. The second term, time series forecasting, refers to generating future values for this specific series of interest. You might have heard the term predict in addition to forecast, and maybe you're wondering what's the difference between them. Actually, they mean the same, but in the world of statistics, we tend to use the word predict in the cross-sectional context, where we have data on many observations at one time point, whereas we reserve the term forecast for a time series context where we're measuring one thing over time. That's similar to the distinction between a still photo and a video. Let's look at an example and some data so that we can start talking about notation and terminology. Taipei is the capital of Taiwan and houses over 2.5 million people. Taipei has a very efficient metro system called the Massive Rapid Transit, or simply MRT. Thousands of people take MRT every day. We gathered data for MRT ridership from the Taipei City website. And here we have data for 20 years of trips on Taipei MRT. We can see that our data have two columns. We have a date, and we have the number of passengers. In this example, we're looking at daily ridership. So we have dates for every single day. You'll notice that I added a column called T. What T is, it's a time index that tells us which period we're in. In this example, T equals 1 is the first day. T equals 2 is the second day. That's because we have daily data. The second notation that we'll use is Y sub T. And YT is the value of the series at time period T. So for example, Y1 is the number of passengers that traveled on MRT on day 1. And in this example, we see that we had 42,548 passengers. A third term and notation that we will use has to do with forecasting. F sub T plus K refers to the forecast or the forecasted value for time period T plus K when we're using data only until time T. This notation K is related to what's called the forecast horizon, which is the number of periods ahead that you want to forecast. In some applications, we're only interested in one step ahead forecasts, and in that case, K will be equal to 1. In other cases, we might want longer term forecasts. For example, if we want monthly forecasts for the next year, then we want K equals to 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 12. And finally, another important notation is E sub T plus K. And E refers to the error, the forecast error, or we also call it a residual. It's the difference between the actual value in our series, what we called Y T plus K, and the forecast at that same time period, which we denoted F T plus K. So E sub T plus K is the forecast error for period T plus K. With these notations, we can start talking about time series forecasting, about building models, and about performance evaluation. Now let's talk for a minute about what a forecasting process is. Forecasting is not a function in a software or a button to run. It includes an entire set of steps, which are often not linear from start to end. It starts with defining a goal, getting the data, then exploring it and visualizing it. There are all kinds of pre-processing steps we'll talk about, and then we're going to apply different forecasting methods, compare them, evaluate them, finally choose one, and at the end we will be implementing some kind of a forecasting system. However, notice that some steps can actually go back. For example, when we explore the data, we might determine that we don't have the right data to solve the problem that we're trying to answer. In that case, we might go back and collect new data. Or maybe when we're comparing our models, we determine that all the models that we tried are not good enough. And in that case, we might actually go back and try some new methods. So remember, forecasting is an entire process, and we're going to be talking about all these different steps throughout the course. Let's look for a minute at the first step, which is defining the goal. Defining the goal requires answering the main question, which is, how will the forecasts be used? To answer that question, we're going to look at lots of different aspects. One aspect is whether the goal is descriptive or predictive. Another aspect is how long we need to forecast for. Do we need to update our forecasts every once in a while? And is our system going to be automated or manual? These are some issues that we would want to tackle. So what is the difference between a descriptive goal and a predictive goal? A descriptive goal is what we call time series analysis, when we're interested in finding out or describing the patterns in the time series that we're looking at. In the MRT example, we might be interested in asking ourselves about daily patterns, weekly patterns, maybe a trend over time. What we're calling time series forecasting, we're interested in something else. We're interested in predicting future values of this series. So once again, in the Taipei MRT example, we would be interested in forecasting future values of ridership or the number of passengers, maybe in the next week, maybe in the next month, but that is very different from the descriptive goal. The bottom line here is that we want to ask ourselves and make sure that we know the answer to whether the goal of the analysis is predictive or descriptive. The reason is that the methods that we use and the performance evaluation metrics and approach will be completely different. So this is one example of the type of question we ask ourselves in the goal definition step. Going back to the goal definition, as I mentioned, there are a bunch of different questions that we might want to ask ourselves to figure out what exactly we're trying to achieve. To read more about these, please take a look at practical time series forecasting. So now you have the basic terminology and language that we will be using throughout this course.